Hello everyone, welcome aboard at my talk. I'm glad to be here with you all. My talk's about fuzzing, find your own bugs and zero days. My name is Rodolfo Concord, but you can call my nickname Rodox. A little about me. I'm implementation tester, instructor of IT, consultant of information security throughout 13 years. I'm certified as a hacker by the council. I already gave talks at the Hack in the Box, Arab Security Conference, Motorola.com, Reddit Village, StackConf, besides Athens, besides Newcastle, besides Attacks, etc. I'm on Torque Hacking 9 magazine about Stack Overflow and Pentest magazine about Kubernetes, from Fuzzy to Get a Shell, from SE8 Override to Get a Shell. I leave here my LinkedIn profile, my email, for who wants to get in touch with me, for take out some doubts, you can write for me at my LinkedIn profile or my email. Our agenda about fuzzy. We will see types of attacks, smart fuzzers, buffer flow, and we have a POC. Types of attacks might be protocol, application file format. Protocol, FTP, POP3, SMTP, TUNET, anyone, any protocol. Application, any push of any application. File format, any file format, MP3, MTU, MP4, for test software reader. Types of attacks. Fuzzers would try combinations of attacks on numbers, charts, metadata, pure binary sequences. It sent for the target on the issue with a sequence of danger string. Again, it sent for the target on the issue with a sequence of danger string. And here we have some example. So we have some example of the danger string. Types of fuzzers might be dumb or smart fuzzing. Dumb, any string combination. Smart fuzzing. Smart fuzzers are programmatic phenology of an input format, a protocol definition or a rules for a file format. Might be mutation, generation, evolutionary. Smart fuzzing is a long subject, and we don't have time for getting getting in depth in this subject. But I leave here IF Secure website with more information about smart fuzzing. Again, we leave here IF Secure website link with more information about smart fuzzing. Buffer flow. Buffer overflow is an anomaly where a program, while writing data to a buffer, overruns the buffer boundaries and overwrites adjacent memory locations. Might be heap-based and stack-based. Heap-based, placing the memory which allocates a lot amount of data in dynamic. Stack-based, allocate a limited or a fixed size of the data, such as data from local variables or functions. Here we have a buffer overflow code example. In this code, we have a variable buffer with size 5 bytes of size. What's the problem with this code? The problem if this code don't verify what it should do if you use insert more than 5 bytes. So if you use insert more than 5 bytes, the application will use core overflow. Again, if you use insert more than 5 bytes, the application will get a crash because the application isn't prepared for what has happened if it's using certain more than 5 bytes. Here we have an image of buffer overflow. Here we have a left image, variable 4 if 11 A's, and right image, variable 4 if 150 A's. As we can see here, this this characters ace overwrite the register EBP. So occur here a Stack Overflow. As we can see in write mails, occur a Stack Overflow because overwrite the register EBP. Now we will see a POC. Discover input form to align the first. Example of the protocol POP3. Here we see in this code, this is a code of fuzzy script, Python fuzzy script. We have here variable buffer with character A, variable counter with 100 A's, and we have here for string in buffer connected to target IP in port 110. And we have here below com the user, com the pass. What will happen with this code? This code will send a lot amount of character A's against the target IP in port 110 in command pass. Com the user in command pass is specified in document RFC 1081. Protocol POP3 uses com the user in command pass. Other protocols use other commands. Each protocol has their own command. Other protocols use other commands. But in this case, of protocol POP3, uses command user command pass. Is this specified in document RPC 1081? Here we have command pass plus string. And here we have for string buffer. We will send a lot amount of character A against this target IP in port 110 in command pass. Again, it send a lot amount of character A in command pass with objective of cause crash in this application. So let's see the video POC. Let's see the video POC. In this video, we will see running any map command against the target IP for CD open ports. As we can see, port 110 is open. It's running protocol POP3. It's running protocol POP3 in port 110. Now let's see our Python fuzzy script. In this fuzzy script, we will send the variable buffer equals character A, variable counter equals 100. Here we have a target IP port 110. In the command user, command pass. In command pass, we have pass plus string. And here we have for string and buffer. So we will send a lot amount of character A against the target IP in port 110 in command pass. So we will send a lot amount of character A in command pass against the target IP in port 110. With objective of cause a crash in this application. Let's run in the Python fuzzy script. As we can see, it was necessary 5,900 bytes for cause a crash in this application. And let's run in any map command again. And then now the port 110 is down. Now port 110 is down. Because cause a crash of our script. Here we have a vulnerable software to download. I'll become available on my LinkedIn profile the link for these slides. For you wanted to see again these slides, I will make available on my LinkedIn profile these slides. This is a link for vulnerable software. Now we see another video POC. Here we have a vulnerable software to download. We will open the vulnerable software in Moonery Debugger. Let's see another video POC. In this video POC, we will teach how you can create your own exploit code. Since make use of fuzzing, send this a lot amount of characters, to get a shell. Here we have variable buffer with a lot amount of these characters. This a lot amount of characters will load in our vulnerable software with objective called crash. With objective called crash in vulnerable software. Here we have output the file that will generate it. This a lot amount of characters will generate by tool pattern create. We will use a tool pattern create to generate a lot amount of characters. Pattern create dash L the length 50,000 bytes. 50,000 bytes. We will copy this a lot amount of characters. Let's copy this a lot amount of characters. And paste in our exploit code. Again, this a lot amount of characters. We will load our vulnerable software with objective cause a crash in vulnerable software. We use this a lot amount of characters for find offset of registry IP. So now let's generate our compiled exploit code with per name of exploit code. And then we have here output of exploit code. We have output of exploit code. Let's move this compiled exploit code to a desktop. Let's copy our compiled exploit code to a victim VM. Let's open the Moonery Debugger. Let's run the vulnerable software. Let's attach the vulnerable software. Attach vulnerable software in Moonery Debugger. Let's run the vulnerable software in Moonery Debugger. Let's load our compiled exploit code in vulnerable software. And we get a crash. Here we have a register ISP with a lot amount of characters. We have here in stack a lot amount of characters. As we can see, we have here in stack a stack overflow. We have overflow in stack. And we have here a register IP with some value. We will use this value in registry IP to find the offset of registry IP. Because we need to get a control of registry IP. Because what the function of register IP? Register IP indicates the next address that the process will execute. Again, the register IP indicates the next address that the CPU will execute. For this, we need to find offset of register IP to find some address that make jump ISP. Because we need to make a jump from IP to ISP. Because here in ISP we put our shell code to get a version shell. Again, here in ISP we put our shell code to get a version shell. For this we need to find some address. We need to find some address that make a jump from IP to ISP. For find the offset of this IP, we use a tool pattern offset. We use a tool pattern offset to find the offset of register IP. Pattern offset dash L length 50,000 bytes dash Q and the value of register IP 79, 53, 35, 1979. This is a value of register IP. We want to find inside the length 50,000 bytes an offset of register IP. And we found offset 35,056. We find offset 35,056. This is offset of register IP. Let's open our exploit code. Open our exploit code. We have here a variable buffer size 50,000 bytes. This is a total of bytes, 50,000 bytes. Variable junk equals x41. x41 means character A. Again, x41 means character A multiplied by 35,056. We will fill with character A up 35,056. After, we will overwrite the register IP with some address that register IP. Here we have variable IP with address that make jump ISP. Again, here we have variable IP with address that make jump ISP. Now let's learn how find this address that make jump ISP. Now we'll learn how find this address that make jump ISP. Because we get the control of the IP to find some address that make jump ISP. To make a jump from IP to ISP. Because in ISP we put our shell code to get a version shell. So let's find a address that make jump ISP. First, we need to find some modules without secure mechanisms. And inside this module, we'll find the address that make jump ISP. We need to find some modules without secure mechanisms, some modules without safe SSH, ASLR as false, NX compate as false. We use a model msvols.dll. Again, we found and we will use a model msvols.dll because this module has a secure mechanism as false. Have safe SSH as false, ASLR as false, and xcompate as false. We're using a module msvols.dll because this module has a secure mechanism as false. Now we use a tool NAS Michel to find the opcode for jump ISP. Type NAS Michel after type jump ISP. For find the opcode for jump ISP. Because we want to find a jump ISP inside this module msgoals.dll. Again, we want to find a jump ISP expression inside this module msgoals.dll. And we found FFE4. FFE4 is opcode for jump ISP. Again, FFE4 is opcode to a jump ISP. Let's type in command bar this command exclamation mona find dash s the search ffe4 that mean jump isp dash m the module msgoals.dll. So we want to find mona find search ffe4 again. Ffe4 means jump isp dash m inside the module msgoals.dll. And we found the address 01BA135B. 01BA135B is a FFE4. It's an address that make jump ISP. FFE4 means jump ISP. Inside the modules msgoals.dll with secure mechanisms as false. So we type here in variable IP this address that make jump ISP. We type unlike because it's a characteristic of the x86 architecture. x86 architecture recur that we override unlike. For this, we type 5B13BA01. We typed 5B13BA01. It's an address that make jump ISP. Again, we type variable EIP, I add this 5B13BA01 because this is an address that make jump ISP. So now we have here some bad shards. What's bad characters? A bad shards. Let's see. Now we need to search for bad characters. Depending on the application type of vulnerability and the protocol in use, maybe these certain characters which are considered bad and should not be used in our buffer shell code. One example of bad characters is a 00. This character is considered bad because a null byte is also used to terminate a stick copy operation, which would truncate our buffer whenever the null byte appears. So, as some characters that will be considered as bad for this application. For this, we will load in our vulnerable software all these characters, CC01 up FF. We load all these characters, CC01 up FF, with objective of find some character that cause error in our buffer. We load this exploit equals junk concatenate with IP concatenate with bad shards. We load all this in our vulnerable software. So now let's save our exploit code. Generate our compact exploit code with per name of exploit code. We have here a compact exploit code. Move a compact exploit code to a desktop. Let's restart our vulnerable software in Mundra Debugger. Restart vulnerable software in Mundra Debugger. Run a vulnerable software. Let's copy our compact exploit code to a victim VM. Copy our compact exploit code to a victim VM. Click the right button, Immunity Debugger, go to expression to find 01BA13FB. This is an address that make jump ISP. Again, this is an address that make jump ISP. And we find here FF4 jump ISP. FF4 is an opcode for jump ISP. So we find here an address 01BA13FB. This is an address that make jump ISP. Because we want to make a jump from YARP to ISP, because in ISP we put our shell code. So now let's put a backpoint in jump ISP. For this, give a double click in FF4. Again, give a double click in FF4 to put a backpoint in jump ISP. Backpoint will stop the flow of execution. We will stop the flow of execution in our jump ISP address. So give a double click in FFE4 to put a backpoint in FFE4 to stop a flow of the execution. Load the compact exploit code immutable software. Load the compact exploit code immutable software. And the flow of execution is stopped in 01BA13FB. As we can see, we have a register EIP. We have a register EIP with 01BA13FB. This is an address that makes jump ISP. So now we got a control of the jump ISP. We stopped the flow of execution in jump ISP address because we need to find a jump ISP. So let's see what has in jump ISP. For this, give a double click in ISP. Again, give a double click in ISP. Right button ISP following dump. And we have here some values 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08. And after 08000000, we have some problem here, some error here, because we don't have here 09080B0C0D and etc. We have here 000000. This is an error here. It's an error cause due some bad characters. This is an error cause due some bad characters. We need to find what is the bad characters to avoid when we create our shell code. So we need to find the bad characters for avoiding bad characters when we create our shell code. I know that in this case, the bad characters is 0A. So let's erase our vulnerable bad shards. Let's erase 0A. Let's erase 0A because 0A is a bad character. I know that in this case, 0A is a bad character. Let's save this exploit again. Save this exploit again. And now let's compile exploit code. Compile exploit code and let's load all these bad variable bad shards in our vulnerable software again. Move exploit compile exploit code to a desktop. So let's restart the Immunity Debugger. Restart the Immunity Debugger. Running the vulnerable soft Immunity Debugger. Click with right button, go to expression. Let's find the jump ISP address 01BA135B. This jump ISP address, give a double clicking jump ISP address. Give a double clicking jump ISP address to put a breakpoint in jump ISP. Put a breakpoint in jump ISP to stop the flow of execution with jump ISP. Copy the compat exploit code to a victim VM. Copy the compat exploit code to a victim VM. We will stop in jump ISP address. Let's load our compat exploit code in vulnerable software. As we can see, the flow of the execution stopped again in jump ISP address. Now let's see the content of register ISP. Let's see the content of register ISP. For this, click with right button ISP, right button ISP, following dump, for see the buffer of ISP. And now we have the value here, 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07, 08, 09, 0B, 0C, 0D, 0E, 0F, and etc. up FF. We don't have more error here. After 09, we have 0B. After 09, we have 0B. Because 0A is a bad character. As we can see, we don't have error more. We don't have error more because now we avoid a 0A. We avoid a 0A because 0A is a bad character. And avoiding a 0A, we don't have an error more. So we, as we can see, we have after 09, we have 0B, 0C, 0D, 0E, 0F, up FF. We don't have error more. We don't have error more. So let's restart Moodle Debugger. Let's restart Moodle Debugger. Running a vulnerable software again, Moodle Debugger. Now I already know that the 00 and 0A is a bad characters. Again, 00 and 0A is a bad characters. Right button, go to expression. Find jump ISP address. Give a double clicking jump ISP address, double clicking FFE4 to put a breakpoint in jump ISP. Double clicking FFE4 to put a breakpoint in jump ISP. Now let's generate our shell code. Generate our shell code to get a reverse shell. For generate our shell code, we use a tool MSF Venom. We will use a tool MSF Venom. We should type msf venom dash p of payload Windows shell reverse TCP and host as our local IP and port 5555 to get the connected back dash f the file per dash e the code shikataganai dash b the benchmarks 0800 dash B of bad characters, we will avoid 0800. So we will generate our shell code avoiding 0800. Again, we're gonna generate our shell code avoiding 0800 because 0800 is a bad characters and cause error in our buffer. So let's generate our shell code avoiding 0800. So let's open again our exploit code. Exploit code have buff size 50,000 bytes as a total. Variable junk x41 means character ace. We will fill with character ace up offset of the IP. 35,056 is our offset of YIP. As we will overwrite a register YIP with address jump ISP, we have variable YIP with address that make jump ISP. Again, we have a address in YIP, we have a address that make jump ISP, because we want to make a jump from YIP to ISP, because in ISP we put our shell code to make a virtual shell. After we have some loops, x90 multiplied by 10, we put some loops. Loops means no operations, because do nothing. Again, loops do nothing. We put some loops in ISP, and after even ISP, we put our shell code. We put in ISP some loops, and after even ISP, we put our shell code. And we have here our variable shell with our shell code. Let's erase this old shell code to paste our new shell code. Let's erase this old shell code to paste our new shell code. Let's copy our new shell code. Copy our new shell code and paste in our exploit code. Paste in our exploit code our new shell code. The shell code is a shell code to make a virtual shell, to get a shell. So we will put in ISP some loops that do nothing. Loops means no operations. And then following our shell to get a virtual shell. Here we have variable exploit equals junk concatenate with YIP, concatenate with loops, concatenate with shell. We load our variable shell, we will load our variable software, all these values, junk, YIP, loops, and shell. We will load all this in our variable software. So let's save our exploit code, and let's compile our exploit code. And then we have an output POC file. We have our compiled exploit code POC file. Let's copy the POC file to a desktop. So let's put netcat to listen on port 5555. Netcat-lnvp on port 5555. Listen on port 5555 to get a reverse shell, to get a connect back. Let's copy our compact exploit code to a victim VM. Compact exploit code to a victim VM. And let's load our compiled exploit code into a vulnerable software. Load the compiled exploit code in vulnerable software. As we can see, the flow of the execution stopped in address jump ISP, stopped in the address jump ISP because we want to make a jump ISP from YIP to ISP. Stop the flow of execution in jump ISP to make jump from YIP to ISP. In ISP, right button ISP following dump. And as we can see in buffer of ISP, we have our loops 90, 90, 90, 90. We have here our loops that do nothing. And after we have After we have our shell code, BAB097, we have here BAB097. This is our shell code. We have here our loops, and after our loops, we have our shell code. After our loops, we have our shell code to get a reverse shell to make a connect back. So let's run our vulnerable software in Vulnery Debugger. And we have a shell. We got a shell in our netcat. We have a shell. Let's see ipconfig, IP of the victim, and netuser for CD user of victim, user Rodox and user administrator. As we can see, we got a reverse shell. We got a reverse shell. Is it? This slide, we have step by step of how you can write your own Sprite code. For who wants to see again, I'll make it available on my LinkedIn profile these slides with step by step of how you can write your own Sprite code. Since of getter, get control VIP. To find a bad characters and make a, and got a reverse shell. Is it? Thank you everyone for watching me. Now I open for the question. Thank you very much.